Hey Joe fans, welcome to another episode of Dave C Straight from the Pit. In this show, we're going to talk about a mint on card, 1986, Mainframe. He's kind of an interesting character because he was one of the first G.I. Joes that didn't come with a weapon, a machine gun or a pistol or even a knife. Mostly because I think that he was the Joe team's computer specialist. And at that time, computers were still kind of in their early invention state. And I thought it was really cool back then that the Joes had a specialist come along because a lot of combat stuff was becoming computerized. He came with the BP-75E transmitter unit, a walkie-talkie, a hose, and a portable combat-ready computer system. I thought his name was pretty cool, but there were actually other prototype names that I wasn't aware of, and one of them was Chip. And a chip, of course, being a small piece of semiconducting material on which an integrated circuit is embedded. Another name that he was maybe scheduled to have was Big Byte, and a byte is the basic unit of measurement for information storage in computer science. And another name that he might have been called was Relay. And a relay is an electrical switch that opens and closes under the control of another electrical circuit. And he was available from 86 and 87 and discontinued in 1988. And as you can see on my example here, the price tag is still there and it's partially ripped off. And that frequently happened back in the day when maybe kids would try to remove it. It didn't really work so well. And I have an interesting story about this particular one that I picked up on Kijiji, which is a free ad up here in Canada. It turns out that the other day when I found this on my home computer, the seller was in the old city where I used to live. So I went to pick it up, not knowing that the guy actually turned out to be somebody that went to my elementary school, the same one as me. And he was actually a couple of years older than me, but he knew all the teachers there, and he knew my brother, and he knew all my cousins, because my Uncle Pete was quite a boisterous guy at the time. He was a baseball coach, and this person kind of remembered those individuals that I just mentioned, and also all the teachers that we had. We talked about that, Mrs. Hurst and Mrs. Wilkinson and Mr. Baker, Mr. White, Mr. Roy. Mr. Roy was actually his favorite teacher, and Mr. Roy was my brother's favorite teacher. So, yeah, this guy actually was more closer to my brother's age than me. But I just think it's really cool that this actual figure that you see here that I'm holding is one that somebody that I went to school with, or went to my school back then, actually came from his house, because he said that this was a double of his, and he had a loose one that he played with his brother, but he had one that they never opened, because it was a double, because I got it for Christmas one year, and he never opened it. He actually had it on his dresser until around the early 90s, and then he put it away in storage, until the other day he actually went through his old stuff. And here it was. So he wanted to sell it. And he gave it to me for a really, really good price. He knew that my son and I collect G.I. Joe, and that we're not just going to take this and try to make money on it, because we don't put prices on things because we don't really care about that. We'd rather just have it in our collection because it means a lot more to us than a monetary value. So here it is here flipped around. And you can see on this example that it has all the 1985 and 1986 guys available. And this file card reads as follows. Codename, Mainframe. Computer Specialist. File name, Blaine L. Parker. Primary Military Specialty, Computer Technology. Secondary Military Specialty, Infantry. Birthplace, Phoenix, Arizona. Grade, E5. Too much of the modern battlefield is computer coordinated, not to have a computer specialist right out there on the field with you. Problem is, most hackers don't exactly fit the combat profile. Mainframe is the exception. He was 10 years older than the next oldest trainee at Paris Island, and he still finished at the top of his class. He's got brains, but he's hard. And you can see here that he had the special offer, a body transfer sticker on the bottom there. And I did have a few of those. I remember I had a beachhead, I'm pretty sure, that came with that. And I know it's pretty crazy that I can remember that, but sometimes when I see something like this and I'm holding it in my hand again, it brings back a lot of memories. And I remember a few 1986 guys having that patch and coming with the transfer. You can see the transfer there behind him in the bubble. So we can take a better look at his loose figure here. And here it is here. He's a gray color with silver and black. And he's a lot of fans' favorite figure. And that doesn't surprise me, because he was quite a specialist in some newer technology that was coming out. And one of the things about him is that he has an infantry patch, that red patch there on his shoulder, or I guess it's his sleeve. And a lot of guys, I remember back then, were kind of like, well, he's not an infantryman if he's a computer guy. But if you read his file card, he actually is an infantryman. That's his secondary specialty. And he does have a holster and a pistol there on his chest. And he does have a knife sheath and a actual K-bar type knife sticking in there. So he does have some weapons. And as a lot of people know, his girlfriend on the Sumbo animated series was this girl here, Zarana. That's Zartan's sister. And if you haven't seen that episode yet, you should check it out. It's called Computer Complications, and it's a bit of a romance story about these two, how they get involved in a taboo relationship, because Mainframe is a G.I. Joe, obviously, and Zarana is a enemy infiltrator. So, but yeah, here's her card here. I'm going to do a review on her another time, but yeah, that's her there. I talked to him about where he got it from back then, and he believes that he got it at a local mall that we'd always go to, a place where I would always get my Joes too most of the time, I mean, other than Toys R Us. And I believe the tag matches up with a store called Robinson's, which was a Canadian store, and now it's out of business, of course, but I believe it to be that. I don't think it's Simpsons or Sears or the Bay. So yeah, I believe it's Robinson's, and I really like having these old tags on there, because it just makes the item more authentic. And I just think it's really neat that the same mall that I walked through and bought all my Joes, or most of my Joes, that he was in the same mall and bought this Joe there as well, back in good old 1986. Okay, dudes, hope you enjoyed watching this video. We'll see you next time, and until then, keep cool, stay cool, and enjoy the beginning of this awesome 2022 summer. Take a ride on the West Coast here.